I'm like breathing on the mic. I really am like in. Just get away from my face, but still be there so you can still hear me. Yes, that'll do. Oh god, it really doesn't like. I peaked at two girls in bar. Oh, I thought they said two girls, one bar. Thirty-nine, 60, 48%, 39%. I thought we did really well in that one. 46%. We got laid in the 46% one. We didn't get anything in the 60% one. Well, I guess that's not the mission. The mission is to learn about women. Right, our first date with Alexa, which is I think the girl on the street. Oh my god, that story continuation.
Hey.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Very nice. You look great.
Thank you, so do you.
Cheers. Well, take a seat. I ordered you some tea.
Thank you,
you
that's
like
perfect.
Tea, right?
I do.
I mean, you're not English, but I'm sure you drink tea too.
I still like tea.
Cool, so how have you been?
Good. Busy.
Yeah, busy?
Yeah, work. Mm-hmm. It's been overwhelming.
You told me, what was it you said? You said you work in a charity or something, but
yeah.
I don't know what it is.
What non-profit animal shelter doing cat rescues.
I have to do this again. I got old. What do you mean I got old? I look fucking young. Come back here. Tell to my face how young I look. Look at this youthfulness in my eyes. I should offer thanks to the 4 months and Indy Cross 6 for the sub. So sorry I'm covering up the questions, but someone in chat called me old looking. Anyway, I don't care about comments. So A, C, B. You decide. A course. The site will tell you how old .net. Loserfruit. Sorry, we're gonna get distracted for a second. And then I'll press A, I think. These are not current photos of me, 1 second. It's a few years ago. Well, these are no recent photos. These are last year, but that's not recent enough. This is back when I had little small eyebrows. That's like the only one that was. That's not even me. Pretty sure that's Sniper Wolf. But this one kind of looks recent-ish. Oh no, thank you. I would like to use this photo. 26! I was about to say that's exactly right, but I'm actually 25. I'm an idiot. I thought I was 26. Sorry. Don't cross streams. Thanks for the sub. We're not ignoring the date. We're getting back to it. Just, excuse me. This is very important to me and my ego. Can't believe it. This is I'm 26. Okay, that one says I'm 23. It says she's 25. There we go. This is more accurate. This one, we're both 31. That's just stupid. Taylor Swift's not 31. Yeah, use this photo of me on 60 Minutes. 27, are you kidding me? But how? How does it know? How does it know? Yeah, this one, 22. Let's just go off that and leave. I have not aged at all. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm 22. Sorry. Anyway, back to... So we're doing A, right? Okay, let's go.
Oh, a cat shelter.
Yeah.
That's interesting because you might have met some cats that I've been in contact with.
Really? I feel like being on this side.
Yeah, what's there? Did a cat come to...
No, I want to look straight at the date.
To you, I don't know, like 6 weeks ago or so, like a ginger one with white spots?
We get lots of those.
Yeah, I guess. Well, this was so funny, right? Me and some friends, we were just out and, you know, bored like you are. And there's this cat, like, in my neighborhood, I often see it. It's very friendly, sure. Like, yeah. This ginger one. And it came up to us like that, right? And we were taking it, like, playing with it. But then we decided we'd tie a little rope around it and attach fireworks all along. So funny. Yeah. And then just lit it. And it was like, meh, poof, meh, poof. Like, that just went mental. Actually, I've got a video. I'll show you.
No, you're joking.
No, it was phenomenal. Look, wait. It's one of the funniest things I've ever seen, actually. Where is it? Look, there it is. The little shit. Look. See him?
Oh, my God.
You see him?
No. How could you do that to a cat? He trusted you. He came
up
to you.
This is where the fireworks.
No, I don't want to see it. You're terrible.
What do you mean?
No, you're absolutely fucking terrible. I'm gonna call the cops.
It likes it,
no,
I think.
No, no, no.
Give me 500 bits. This is perfect. No.
In the game, that's cool. In real life, totally illegal.
Be nice about cats. See, I actually prefer dogs. We'll be get you a pass. We don't want that. You like.
A cat shelter, really?
Yeah. Oh, that's so...
Sorry. I really should have been more prepared for today's stream. There you go. We need chat up in a more of a corner so you know exactly what's happening. Let's not associate my sponsors with this stream.
Sweet. So you're just doing that and I guess you don't get paid like millions to work there.
No, yeah? It's very small and usually actually free.
Very cool.
Yeah, it's good. It's nice. It helps out a lot.
So you love cats and you just decided to do something.
Yeah, I love all animals, but cats here need most help.
That's great. So. I'm sure people love you for that then.
Some people.
Most people like cats. I like cats.
Yeah, do you?
Yeah.
That's good. Do you have any?
No.
Well, you should stop by and I can maybe help you find one.
Okay. Well, actually, I travel a lot, so it's not good, but
okay.
I can come by and just, you know, play with them and whatever, and then
that would be nice.
Cool. When someone does something like this, you know, charity, something that they really care about, don't tease it, don't take the piss, don't be rude about it, connect on it. So what does your work entail there? Are you, like, you know, holding
a
ball of string all day playing with the cats?
Has it got no
serious stuff?
That's part of it, but actually we do transports nationwide. So if the shelter is full, then we find someone who can take it elsewhere in the country to save its life.
Okay.
That's actually the reason it's been really busy is a cat I had adopted. I lost him. So
you lost him?
He's been adopted and I opened his cage and he ran out. And I don't really know how to tell the people.
So he's like somewhere in the building or
yeah,
he could
hopefully
be anywhere?
He could be anywhere. He may have found his way outside. But I don't know how to tell the people. So maybe you have an idea?
Advise her to buy a cat that looks the same. Tell her to be dishonest and see if she agrees to check her. Tell her to act as if it never happened and recommend that she tell the truth. See, the thing with this game is that whatever you pick, it's one, it will surprise you. You pick one option and it just, you don't know what's exactly happening. I want to see B, to be honest with you. I want her to be dishonest and like be like, oh, it's just a game. But you want A, you want D, you want C, you want A. No. AAB, AAB.
Well, why don't you just find a cat that looks the same, like buy a new one that kind of looks similar and say, there he is.
It's going to be a pass.
You're not really supposed to buy cats. It defeats the purpose of the shelter. We made and he's love. Pretty distinct. I don't think it would work in this realm.
I guess so.
Yeah.
You're suggesting a dishonest course of action, so think about what that says about you.
I actually don't think you told me
I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, I didn't, did I?
That's my fault. I should have pressed B. I'm sorry. boring truth. I'm a QA manager for a software company that creates inventory systems. Joke. I run a beating school for small pets, hamsters, and gerbils mostly. Braggadocious lie. Is that really a word? That one right there. Is that really a word? Right. Braggadocious? I mean, I know what it's trying to imply, but damn, I want that to be a real word. It's a word? Oh. Life is good. I've learnt a new word today. It's only like 8 a.m. I'm one of the top 10 real estate brokers in the country. I just sold a property to Donald Trump for $1 billion. Dismiss it. It's not important. Life's too short to talk about work. A bragging lie. A braggadocious lie. It sounds braggadocious, but I don't think I ever dropped a pass in this game. Dropped a pass. C A C D B C D D B B C C D C C.
You don't know? I thought you would have checked, Googled me or something.
Oh no, it's going to make her laugh. We're going to pass.
Because I'm one of the top real estate brokers in the country and just closed a $1 billion deal with the Trump, Donald.
Really?
Yeah.
Big stuff.
You like him?
Well, I like money. Yeah. He's got money.
He's so not I a guess good person. I like him.
Well, real estate's real estate, right? I'd probably sell something to Saddam Hussein or Osama bin Laden if they were still with us.
That's a little concerning, but I guess if you're good with business, that makes sort of sense.
Yeah.
I mean, money's money, right? And let's imagine I get this billy from Donald Trump and then I give it all to charity, right? Give it to a cat shelter. Then it makes it good, right?
Deal?
Deal
you
billion.
Give the money to the cat shelter.
I can give some money to the cat shelter.
Then it's fine.
$5 or something. That's something.
Okay.
Give a little back.
Sure.
Lies will get you into trouble, and unless you move very, very fast, you're going to get caught
Alexa.
Out. And even if you don't get caught out, it's a recipe for disaster. So if you're not satisfied with where you are in life,
Alexa, stop letting us pass.
So that you
bullshit.
Never need to lie.
So what do you do outside of work?
What do I do? So I do some fitness stuff, and I study languages.
I should move my face where the woman's face is, so I can make the responses to his, reactions. So I'll do that when we're doing a repeat of it. I got this. It's coming up. We'll do a rewind. Some dumb fuck. Thanks for the sub and solid joke gamer. Thanks for the 9 months.
And
happy baby name.
What else? I play chess as well.
I don't know how to play chess.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You don't know how the pieces move or you can't play very well?
I can move them. I just don't know how the game
You know
game
what
works.
They're called? Like the horse and whatever.
Is there a rook?
Rook or castle,
okay.
Yeah.
I know some.
Okay. Well, it's quite easy to learn and it's really, I think it's quite cool for the brain. My mum bought me a chess set and then
great.
I thought, okay, it can't just sit there. I'm going to learn how to play.
Cool. You have to teach me.
Mm-hmm. And what else? I like photography. It's probably actually my major hobby. The thing I spend the most time doing is photography.
Oh, that's great. Why do you like it?
Well, actually, there was this time when I just borrowed a friend's camera and I just took some pictures and I loved it. And then everywhere I was going, I was looking at things and thinking, oh, that would make a nice shot. I took some pictures of friends
you
and, they
need
all use
money
it in their Facebook
out.
Profile pictures. And stuff
like a headshot.
Yeah, so I just really got into it. And I guess I might have some talent. So, I keep it. But it's just a hobby. I'm not thinking about it too seriously.
Well, it sounds like you're having fun. That's great.
I can take your picture if you like. Do you like having your picture taken?
Sure, yeah, we could try.
Cool.
I could use a new profile photo.
Yep. When you have something that you like doing, why not be a little bit passionate about it? Tell her why. Try and, you know, get that infectious emotion spread to her. So yeah, that's the right answer.
So I actually do photography too.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
What camera do you use?
It's Canon 5D Mark III.
It's a good one. It's better than mine.
Oh yeah? What do you have? iPhone?
A 40D. And yes, in an iPhone. But I use a 40D.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I actually got into photography because I modeled.
Okay.
Kind of still do a little
can
bit.
Females in the chat. Sorry, just side note. Females in the chat. Can we all agree? Do we think he is attractive? Someone has asked if they want to know if he's attractive or not to a female or to someone who's interested in men. Is he attractive? Why? Nay. I said to the females in chat, it's got to be one. I wish I was like him. No, it's not really my type either. There's one, excuse me, I checked my YouTube demographics lately. Say hi, YouTube. And you know what it said? It usually says like 10%, 9% females to 90%, 91% males. But this time it said 84% males. Huh? No, I think I just lied. 86% males and 14% females. Ugh, you were out there. Hi. Good. Anyway. Oh shit, what did she say? Oh shit, okay. We got a hand modeling. Be very impressed. Does that mean if I make some money I can take pictures of you in lingerie? I thought I saw you in deepthroat.com. Please don't Google that. Not that I have, but I can imagine if one would, it would be bad. Nice, it's hard work, but can be interesting, right? Especially if you like travel. Which countries have you worked in? Let me tell you what I think about that. And then farts.
Ah, so you model. Yeah, I was going to say, right, but, you know, you mentioned it first, so I guess I can, but I definitely saw you on a website. You know, do you have your campaigns and videos and different things in different places?
Yeah, there's a portfolio on there.
Yeah, I think there was this video on Pornhub. What was it?
No.
I don't remember.
Like, someone that looked like me,
deep
maybe.
Deep throat something, but... So it was, yeah,
no.
It was definitely
it was
you.
Certainly me.
Don't be ashamed. Come on.
No. It just wasn't me. Wasn't me.
Okay. Wasn't you.
Wow.
But just so you know, like, you sure can suck a dick.
Oh my god. Fuck you. Out.
Where
that's
are you
that's
going?
Disgusting.
Let's make some movies. Dirty little bugger.
His lines though. Like, they're so bad and so good. He never gets embarrassed by what he says. He was always just like... Anyway. Now we go with F, because we
it's
are
really
very
interesting
mature.
That you said that. Let me tell you what I think about that.
Okay. Oh my god. Are you serious?
What?
That's disgusting.
I was only joking.
No.
Hang on a minute. I might need to go to fix this in the bathroom. I'll be back. Hang on. I know it's so hard sometimes, but just try and hold it in there as long as you can.
Riches! I know it's hard sometimes, but just try to hold it in there. We've learnt a new word and we've learnt that too. Anyway, we'll do C and then
so you do modelling and I take pictures, so maybe I could take your picture sometime.
Yeah, that could be fun.
And you do like lingerie, shots, bikini, these things?
No, bikini maybe, but they'd have to be very like classy.
How much money? Like, I mean, because we could do it for fun, but I could also pay you. So if I gave you some cash, would you get your tits out, for example?
No.
No?
No.
Well, you haven't heard how much yet. What about
it doesn't matter.
A couple hundred?
No. It's an ethics thing. Not interested.
And I could sign something that it's not going to be on my website, like girlsivebanged.com.
So for your personal use, you want
just
photos
for my
of me
use.
Naked?
Yeah.
No.
Just for my
absolutely
personal
not. No.
Use.
Good luck finding someone. You should maybe check Craigslist.
Craigslist, yeah. You say? And what do I search for?
Not the way to do it. You want to offer just some normal photos, and when she's on the actual shoot, just try and get it a little bit more racy, step by step, give her some drinks and see what happens.
Richard. He's always speaking from personal experience. Anyway, for the real answer, which I actually haven't read, what hand modeling? That's a bit rude. Be very impressed. Nice, it's hard work, but it can be interesting, right? Especially if you like to travel. What countries have you worked in? I think it's E. You know, you gotta ask a question, yeah, E. What hand modeling? I kind of want to press A, though. But you know what's gonna happen? Bloody Bedroom Richard is gonna come in and be like, can we call him Bedroom Dick from now on? Bedroom Dick is gonna come and just be like, see, that's not the right way. I mean, you could say something like that, but it's not the right way. And we're going to need a pass again. And I can't get below 50% for another game. I tried so hard last game and I still got below 50%. Okay.
Well, that's cool. Actually, I know a lot about it through the photography, but
right.
It's quite hard work, isn't it, actually?
Yeah.
People think it's easy, you know, just sitting there having pictures taken.
Yeah, there actually is a lot of hard work. You have to know all your best angles and you know,
practice posing and whatever.
Yeah, and have emotion in your face. You can't just have a blank face, and that's actually much harder than people think.
Especially at the end of a long day, right? You're tired and the lights are on. And
the shoes hurt.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
But there are
hard.
Pluses, right? So did you get to travel to any cool countries for modeling?
Never out of the country yet, but I've been to a lot of states and different cities.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, good. Well done. Now, think about how you can apply this as well in your life. Think about how, even if you're not connected to a subject, you can kind of learn how to be empathetic.
She's very happy
empathetic,
with herself
not
right now.
And try and put yourself in their position, feel how they might feel, and think about why they would choose to do that. So, you know, that kind of thought allows you to have
your
very nice, connected conversations.
Seducer.
And this is an example of it. So you've got your cat shelter work, you did some modeling, you did some photography, so you're already pretty busy, right?
Yeah.
Do you have time for anything else?
I like to hike a lot. I like to be outside, you know, being in the shelter and modeling, you're usually indoors, so it's nice to get outside, and I don't like being in the gym, so hiking is like my way of working out.
Yeah, it's very good exercise and fresh air and all that as well.
Yeah, But I also really like, you know, staying in sometimes and just like watching a movie.
Oh, movies, okay. Mm-hmm. What's like the best movie you've seen that you really love recently? A nice
recently?
Hard overall, so like
oh, it's
recently.
So silly, but it's kind of like a guilty pleasure movie, but Jurassic World.
Jurassic World, as in the recent Jurassic movie? Obviously the option's E that we said, but like, don't we really want to impress someone that likes Jurassic Worlds? B, 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 P, brain. I don't really care about this date all of a sudden.
Wait a minute. Why did I invite you on a date? If you like that, you've obviously got a P brain.
No.
How can you like that movie? It's shit.
Because it's silly. It's not supposed to be serious.
But it's not entertaining, it's not funny, it's just dumb bullshit. Only an idiot could like it, come on.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, then I don't know.
What's your IQ? Did you have an IQ test? Or you probably weren't even smart enough to click the button and say start test, yeah?
You know, I think I'm going to stay here and finish my tea because I'm so stupid. And you should maybe go down the street to the library and find yourself a smart girl.
Well, I don't even need to go to the library to find a girl smarter than you. You could find one, I don't know, like retarded mental institute, probably.
Good.
It's a very, very dumb movie, but she's still a sweet girl and she might have other good points other than her taste in films. So a little bit harsh, wasn't it?
Yes, Bedroom Dick, yes. We know what we did. Although that could be like, yeah, you're right. That's probably the best conclusion both of them could have. Why are we continuing on with a charade when that was probably the best timeline of all the timelines available? So E's obviously the right option. Ask if she understood it and explain the key events. Then we'd have to listen to the key events. just playfully tease her.
I can't believe you admitted that. You really
you guys
like
it. Yeah, you're like, let's
I had to
get
be
it.
Honest, it's a guilty pleasure movie. And it was recent. You asked recent. It just came into my head.
I don't know if it makes you look kind of dumb or if it's...
Really?
Or if it's like honest and sweet that, you know, cute that you like it.
I hope honest and sweet.
Probably. Because I'll tell you, like, one of my favorite movies is Predator with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Sure, yeah.
But if
same,
you like
I think
it
that's
too.
Silly.
Yeah.
But it's silly. It's the same. Same
All right, nice one. Okay, cool. I like it. Good. You didn't judge me for liking Predator.
No. Notice that this is playful, it's not insulting. So if you can find that perfect line where you're able to tease without hurting people, you can use it quite often. There's an example. Good choice.
So what sort of movies do you like?
The movie
I know everyone
he likes
says it,
is
but I
Predator.
Do have a varied taste. So if you looked at my iTunes, I've got foreign movies, you know, Korean, French,
wow.
Spanish.
A lot of subtitles.
Yeah, lots of subtitles. I don't know.
Oh, that one
hit,
that one hit deep.
And what else? I've got like the silly action movies, all the Schwarzenegger stuff, and then like the Pinero. De Niro it's like De Niro and Pacino, so yeah,
right.
We can use that for
you
the
like
genre.
Them. You like them both?
Yeah, like the mafia stuff, Heat, right. You know, all of
anything
that.
Recent?
Recent movie.
So I don't care about, I've never seen the movie Predator, it wasn't a diss on Predator, it's just of all the names. If you've seen some of this game and you've seen him act like a total predator, it's just like... It's too good. anyway. Oh, shit, I wasn't paying attention. 50 Shades of Grey. You just find bondage really sensual. I really don't have time for movies. I don't even own TV. Life is about living, not sitting in front of a screen. My favorite movie is one we'll make in the bedroom. What did she say? What is the context of this reply? Oh, it's definitely probably intentional, Cubic, and I love it. Did she say 50 Shades? No. Which one? Awful, there's no good option. Recent movies she likes. Oh, he likes. Like, I feel like the answer's A, but I don't want it to be. Because no one likes this one, let's be real.
Well, I'm thinking of a good movie, but it hasn't been made yet. Let me tell you about it.
Sure.
The stars, me and you.
Okay.
The location, what would be good? Like an all-white bedroom, you know, just everything white. And then what's going to happen? Well, I guess we'd start with some gentle kissing, move on to some... sucking and licking.
Oh my.
And then take it from there. So
no.
It's gonna be great.
You're joking.
Am I joking? Do you want me to be joking? Then
a
I'm joking.
Okay.
I got you there, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. You had me a little nervous.
Yeah. No, I wasn't thinking of that. Just being silly. Yeah, so movies I like action movies basically. Action like, you know, Schwarzenegger. Stallone. He's kind of classic action movies.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great. You know, if you do like filming movies, cool. But wait till you're in a relationship, or at least you've slept with her a few times. Then she might agree.
That's like, you've so seen times where that's happened. Not to that extent, but times which someone has said a joke and it hasn't quite landed. So they're like, should I be joking? And then... Then they're kind of just joking, yeah. Alright, 50 Shades, I guess. Let's go.
I missed it at the cinema, but I just saw 50 Shades of Grey.
Mm.
Have you seen it?
No, I heard it was bad.
As a movie, it's bad, but you know what's cool? It's just all this stuff about, you know, tying girls up and having a little dungeon in your house where you have all of the, you know, all of the accessories and whatever.
It's a little silly, a little over the top.
Are you, I mean, is it too personal for me to ask, but are you into any of that stuff? At least, you know, blindfolds, handcuffs, being tied up?
Might be too personal for now.
Okay, well, I like it.
Okay, but, you know, in the real world, don't get so sexual so fast.
Are you serious? B is the worst answer of the three.
Slowly, bit by bit.
I don't just have time for movies. I just have just a life so much better than your life.
Actually, I just threw my TV in the trash, and I don't really go to the movies. I think that, you know, when it comes to all this, there's just more important things in life to do than sitting down watching something passively. Why don't you read a book?
That's true. That's fair. I actually kind of like that answer.
Good, good. This is an option, you know, where you've chosen to be a little bit out there, a little bit straight and direct, but then she's actually followed you into it and validated it. So it's quite risky, but when you take a big, you know, position like that and you can convince them to it, it's very attractive.
And I like, you know, really talented actors, but...
Sure.
What do you think? Would you be a good actress? Could you, like, cry on call?
I don't know. Probably not.
Are you a good
liar? That sounds
hard.
No, I'm not. I'm really not.
That's kind of connected, right?
I can lie for, like, a minute, and then I feel really bad about it, and I admit it right away.
So I'm not sure if you'd be good, but do you have any other talents?
I play the violin.
Yeah, really?
Yeah. Wow. Since I was, like, 5.
And you still do it? You kept it up?
Not as much as I should, but yeah.
Well, that's impressive.
Thanks. It's hard.
Okay. Because we weren't trying already. Oh, I love them all. These ants are so good. Show off by showing what you can do with your tongue. Do you think he can do the thing where he curls? Show off with a stack of cash and tell her it could be hers. Ask her where she lives so that she asks you back, and then show her your dick. 4 answers you'll never hear in a legitimate game show.
Well, playing the violin is great, obviously. I don't know if I can compete with that as far as talents go, but I do have something that I think you're going to be impressed with.
Like, okay.
I'm just sending you a picture. Do you have your phone here?
No, I'm sorry. Oh,
okay.
I left it in my car.
I'll send it, so you're going to have it to keep.
Okay. But
let me show you this. I've just sent it to you. Look
at that. Oh my god.
Yeah, I know, right?
No, that's not okay.
Ooh, it's very, what do you mean it's not okay? It's way above average, but 10 inches.
You're dreaming,
What's
and I'm
wrong?
Leaving.
What are you doing? You like small dicks or what?
How sweet, you gave her a lasting record.
Tongue or cash? One of these is gonna pass. That's the worst part, is that you don't know which way he's gonna go with them. I don't think I have any choice in the matter of, like, where he's gonna take it. You wanna see the tongue one? I feel like the tongue one's gonna be a pass one, and that the B one is gonna be the fail one. But we'll do the tongue one. I feel like they'll laugh and then they'll start tonguing each other and then I'll get banned.
Well, violin takes a lot of practice, doesn't it?
And yeah, it does.
I've got something I practice every day as well.
Yeah?
Like, check this out. And then look.
That took you a long time to learn.
Well, it's practice, isn't it? So I could do it quite quickly, but now the muscle is just so strong, it never gets tired.
Which is
good for speaking all the languages.
You know,
because learning languages and rolling the R's and whatever.
Good.
Don't come and think about things that you need to show a girl, tell a girl, in order for her to like you more. She'll actually like you more if you're cool and chilled and don't reveal these things, as if you don't have to, because you're already enough. And that's going to make her curious and make her work harder for you.
She didn't hate that, but she didn't love it, though. How do you get above 50%? I've only gotten one right answer so far. Crossed arms, not a good sign. Getting pretty hostile. Oh, Not so hostile anymore. Oh, wait, she's still... Arms crossed means that she's subconsciously thinking of hugging you. This is a good sign. Arms crossed indicates that she is not yet open to you. This is not a good sign. A generic white guy. I know what they would do after a sub. They would hug her.
No, that's just plain wrong.
Oh, come on. Where's the scene?
It means she's closed, usually. This is not an absolute rule, but in most cases it's correct, so well done.
I wish I had, like, someone here so I could, like, get them to reenact it. I'll be this guy because I think, like, I've really learned a lot about him the past 5 episodes. So I think I could really imitate it. You want to know if she likes you? Ask her if she likes you. Tell a lame joke and see if she laughs. Use self-pity to fish for compliments. Well, B's going to be the right answer, actually. C's going to be the wrong answer. Ask her if she likes you. Is primary school level. Really, let's just do B.
Oh, can I tell you a joke?
Yeah.
I've got a brilliant joke. Okay, how does it go? What is red and smells like blue paint?
I don't know.
You don't know, do you?
No.
Red paint.
Yeah, it's good.
Brilliant, right? I love that.
Absolutely
one.
Brilliant.
One of the biggest signs of interest that a girl can give is if she laughs at your lame jokes. Doesn't mean you need to consciously remember this lame joke and use it, but you can pay attention to, you know, moments where you think, hang on, she's laughing and I didn't really say anything funny. Yeah, don't worry, it means she likes you.
Funny joke.
Learn that lesson. And how about your family? Do they live...
I recently came across your other channel, Finding Loser, and watched one of your video about your New Year's story, and I just want to say you are not alone. Everyone deals with it also. You coming out and being so open about it is inspiring. We love you.
Thank you. Finding Loser is my favorite channel to... make stuff for. No, thank you.
They live in the city as well?
No, I moved away from home. Which is, yeah, it's sad. I miss them. I miss seeing them.
When did you leave? When you were, like, teenager? You ran away?
No.
Rebellious teenager?
No, for school. For school. And then okay. I just stayed here.
But you get on well with your family? You don't hate
yeah,
them?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I actually I have a twin sister and we're very close.
Oh, yeah?
Tell her about your twin sexual fantasy. I kind of want to hear that. Dizzy 14 does it. Thanks for 3 months. Sorry for overcommitting you there. Ask if they have a special bond. Tell them you'd like a twin because you hate most people but like yourself. Ask a series of questions to find out more. Twincest, then hating myself, no, hating other people, and then...
Twins? Wow. Yeah. No way. That really gets me thinking. Because, yeah, I've got all of these, you know, fantasies. And I didn't know you had a twin. So maybe, yeah. So, for example, like, when we're already having sex, like obviously not now because we've met recently, but when we're having sex already and we're kind of dating, and then sometimes you could send your twin and I don't know. Mm-hmm. And then I'm having sex with her, but then you come in, like, surprise, yeah. You're having sex with my twin.
Right.
And can I join you as well?
Yeah.
And, like, I know, let's see which twin is better at... giving blowjobs, and then let's compare your asses, are they identical, and
right.
Are your pussies identical,
yeah.
And all of this stuff. It's gonna be brilliant. I'm so happy. It just doubles how much I like you. And I already liked you a lot.
And this is actually just nothing new for me, and it's rather boring, so
nothing
I'm gonna go
new.
And give her
so
a
how many
call.
Times have you done it? How many men have you shared? What? This is one of those cases where you don't say what you think. So obviously if you meet a hot girl who's got a twin, a normal man's going to think very, very, very first thing, need a threesome with those two twins. But she knows that, so don't say it.
A normal man is going to think this immediately? Can we have confirmation from more normal men in the chat? It's true, yeah. What question mark? Normal man. You guys are the closest in normal man. Yeah, no. To be honest, there's a lot of people saying yes, and I'm surprised how honest you were. So.
That's fine. It's just funny.
Hmm. I see.
Do you have a twin?
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually so jealous because I hate most people, but I get on well with myself. So if there was another of me, or even another, like triplets or something, and we could all just hang out and, like, I don't know, just diss other people, talk shit about other people because we like each other and we're all the same. Like,
yeah.
So cool.
But maybe I'd like your brother more than you.
My brother?
Yeah.
Why? He's the same.
He looked the same, yeah.
Well, I mean, you could meet him if I'm busy. But no, I'm joking. Of course, I'd always want to meet him. If you like me, then you meet my brother as well. It's like double fun for you, right?
True.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
If that's true, don't say it. If it is true, guess what?
What?
Don't say it.
She laughed. What? How is that a fail? I thought that was at least a pass worthy. She was like, sure. Yeah, sure, and laughed and smiled. Whatever.
Oh, what's your twin's name?
Rebecca.
Rebecca, yeah. And who was born first? Cause
she was.
Yeah.
Minute.
1 minute?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. So she's 1 minute older. And what star sign are you both?
Cancer.
Cancer, that's like July-ish, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's interesting. And Does she like the same stuff as you? Like, does she play the violin and whatever?
Why is he asking so many questions?
That's cool. Mm-hmm. And who gets more dates between you?
Oh, I don't know. I'm not sure about that.
Yeah. That's good. Well, I'd like to meet her. Do you think she would like me as well?
I don't know.
That's interesting, right? Like, if you like someone, does she like someone that you like? And
yeah.
If she likes them, do you like them?
Or
she
doesn't like them? We generally like the same people.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's interesting. I've got so many questions about twins because it's just, don't meet many.
Do you have any good ones?
Yeah. Let me think. I'm going to have more questions for you. But it's really interesting. I might write some down, and then next time we meet, I want to ask you because it's, for me, it's a really cool subject.
All right.
Series of questions is never the way to go. It's not what leads to connection.
Sorry.
It's not teasing, doesn't make her feel anything, not interesting, and it's likely to make her more and more closed as you continue.
So what about your family?
The other option was ask if she has a special bond, and I thought he was going to take that in a very sexual way, so I went for the one that wasn't. I'm sorry, we keep getting passes, I'm sorry.
I've got family.
Okay, good.
No, I don't have any brothers and sisters, and people say that makes me like selfish, but no, I don't
Does
think
it?
So. No, I don't think so. And I'm quite close to my mum. My dad's Italian, so I see him sometimes, but less often. And what else? I have five children.
Really?
Yeah, but they don't live in the country. They're like all in different countries, so that's okay.
You're joking.
Yeah, I'm joking.
Okay, good.
Yeah, no children and no wife.
Okay, that's good. That's ideal.
You want to increase the attraction. Say that you like kind people, so ask what she has done for others. Tell her you recently won a strength competition at the gym. Say that your ex-girlfriend is now dating Drake. Neg her by saying that she looks like Hillary Clinton. Smoothly show her your penis. Dick, dick, dick. And the crowd slowly chants E. That's a good one. It's a good one. Let's go with E again.
You work in the shelter, but do you have any cats yourself?
I do.
How
actually,
are you
going to
turn
two.
That into dicks?
Oh, okay, tell me about them.
Let's see. The one of them, he's actually really special needs. He's deaf and he has asthma. He's allergic to like every food in the whole world. The other one's just really sweet and kind of general.
Oh no! Look what happened.
Oh my god.
Game over, motherfucker. You blew it.
That was tough. Oh no. Don't say I do that. It said smoothly. I mean, like, as far as, like, pulling your dick out to someone who doesn't want to see it, I don't think there's, like, a smooth way about that. So I guess it's as smoothly as it goes for this one condition.
You work in the shelter, but do you have any cats yourself?
Tell us. I do, actually. I have two.
Oh, okay. Tell me about them.
Let's see. The one of them, he's actually really special needs. He's deaf and he has asthma. He's allergic to, like, every food in the whole world.
Sorry, I want to see the Oh No again.
The other one's just really sweet and kind of gentle.
Oh no, look what happened.
Oh my god!
Game over, motherfucker. You blew it.
Oh no, look what happened. His eyes. Shall we say...
Game over, unicorn, you blew it.
Game over, motherfucker. Sorry, it has language filter because this is a very kind of family-friendly stream.
It's always a great time when you stream. Less than three.
I'm gonna believe your lie thanks to the 3 months. So which one are we doing? D? C? B? A is probably the good one, right? Mm-hmm. Sorry, it's getting close to my bedtime.
I was trying to think who you remind me of, and I think I've got it. Has anyone ever told you that you're like Hillary Clinton?
No.
No?
No.
No one?
No. Well, in what way, exactly?
Well, not really in the way you look.
Okay, that's good.
I mean, she's old. She's slightly or a lot older. I'm not sure how
slightly.
Old you are. And then, but something about, like, you're poised, you know? You're like a strong woman.
Okay, well, that's actually kind of nice. Thanks. Yeah.
Now, it is kind of cool to tell a girl that she looks like a famous person. You should be careful who you choose. Porn stars and aging politicians. Not so much.
Oshman, thanks to the 3 months. Even though the ending at Santa Rick said they're 38 months. She seemed okay with it, just saying, okay, so strength competition, that's going to get a pass. Or is this going to get a win because it's going to make her laugh and that's going to get a pass? Ex-girlfriend, you don't really generally bring up ex-girlfriend on a date sort of thing. So B or A, that's what we're going for. Zish Dimmel, thanks for a sub. Welcome to Frutopia. You would A. But, like, why would you ask what someone has done for others? Isn't that a bit strange? Alright, whatever.
So, yeah, I'm close with my mum and, you know, my family. And actually, I keep in touch with some of my exes as well. Hope you don't think that's weird.
No, I do the same.
Yeah, I was talking to one of my exes yesterday and she was telling me, like, she misses me and stuff. Now she's dating Drake.
Oh.
And she's like, you know, you're much cooler and better and whatever. But, you know, that's alright, but... You know, good for her. She's in LA doing her modeling stuff and whatever. You know, moving on is always good. She wasn't the one, so I had to just get rid of her and, you know, let Drake have her.
Yeah, good for her.
Unless she specifically asks, I don't think this is something that you needed to reveal.
So, do you go on mini dates?
It's funny you should mention that. I was thinking of a way to say, but actually I need to leave soon because I've got some other chick waiting. I forgot.
Wow.
Becky or Sam.
Yeah, you should definitely get going.
Yeah, well, but no, we have time to finish our tea and stuff.
No. I'd hate for you to be late.
Really?
Yeah,
you don't mind?
Not at all.
Okay, great. So I'm gonna go meet her, and we will be in touch.
Sure.
Right. You got the check, is it all right?
Yeah.
I'll get it next time.
All right. Fucking loser.
Although if you're like me, you probably have an endless schedule full of countless
Richard,
women.
Richard.
You don't need to tell them all about it.
If you're like me... Alright, a few haven't met anyone special yet. Not really, but she is special. Lie.
But to be honest, yeah, of course, I'm single, so I go on a few dates.
Sure.
But
Haven't met anyone special yet. I, to be honest, I do have another date planned like this week.
I guess that's okay.
But you know what? We're not together like a couple right. yet, so I'm not going to lie and say, oh, you know, well, I already know you're the one for me or whatever. let's take our time, and if we get serious, then of course, you know, I'm a monogamous guy. I'll just be honest with you. I do have another date lined up this week. But
well, thank you for being honest.
Yeah, and you're really cool. So
thanks.
Exactly. Remember, honesty is the best policy. You know, and you'd think in dating it doesn't apply, but you can see here how being honest is refreshing and actually builds attraction. So try and be honest in cases where it won't hurt you, like this.
And what about you? Do you go on a lot of dates?
I mean, I would say, I guess, average, you know.
What's average? 16 a week?
For you, maybe, no. You know, a couple times a month, I guess. It's kind of hard dating in the city. It's not exactly easy to meet people.
Yeah.
You know?
Where'd you meet them? Usually online or real world?
I have tried the dating apps, but I don't like them. I like meeting people in real life.
It's,
you know,
better,
you get
right?
a better idea of, like, who they are.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, like, what kind of girls do you like?
Well, I like kind of, I do like big boobs, mm-hmm. you know, small boobs are okay, but I kind of like a handful, so let me just measure up.
Oh! Fucking pig!
What?
You deserved that one, didn't you? Just describing the physical makes it look like you're a guy that just wants sex, in any case.
Alright, so next option. I gave you what you want even before I knew what you were going to say. TN, thanks for the sub. Describe her physically. Describe the physical opposite. Say that you want a girl who is honest, trustworthy, kind, and intelligent. The worst part is... Excuse me, sorry. The worst part is that we don't know where he's going to take it. He could go on a crazy tangent with her physically, describing her bosoms and buttocks and all those things. And with this one, he could be super charming, but like... You won't be. This could be a pass, though. Oh, I don't know.
I like really kind of brash, you know, fun-loving blonde girls.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like those kind of beachy type.
Sure.
And you know, if she's got some, I don't know, if she works in some kind of sexy industry, it's a bonus. Someone who likes partying a lot as well, hard drinking, having fun.
Yeah,
it's great.
Seduce
me less than 3. Very bad. That's not going to make her like you. It's not going to make her work hard for you. It's just going to make her think less of you.
And tell me, what kind of men do you like?
Tall, dark, and handsome. Typically, really outdoorsy. I guess maybe he can be husky sometimes. Kind of looks like a lumberjack. Maybe?
You said B.
Okay.
It's not my fault. So she likes lumberjacks kind of look. Say that you chop trees and have some axes in the house. Say that's pretty stupid. You like men in suits. I may not be a lumberjack, but I definitely have some foreign hardwood for you. Say that you have a checkered shirt and walked in the park yesterday. Say okay, that's interesting. Okay, that's interesting.
I might not be a lumberjack, but I do have some, you know, English hardwood. For you.
Wow. That's cheesy and kind of gross.
Yeah, there's not hardwood in England. It's like tropical, isn't it? Brazilian hardwood.
I don't know.
So like English, just English wood, run of the mill.
Average.
Well, no, not average. Special.
Special.
Anyway.
Alright.
That's just uncalled for.
Why? She laughed though. Okay, that's interesting. This one? Seems the most boring answer ever. It also seemed like an answer that's gonna get us a pass. You want C, B, C, A. D is a pass. B. Let's just do B.
I wish you'd said earlier, I've got this plaid shirt, and what do I mean, lumberjacks have beards, so I've got the mm-hmm. beard. What else? Outdoorsy. I mean, yeah, I like the outdoors. I was walking in the park, you know, earlier.
Sure.
Like 2 weeks ago, I went for a walk in the park. So that's cool. I think
pretty similar to what you describe. Yeah.
Cool.
No, you're falling into the trap of getting emotional and reacting to the challenge and trying to match up. It's not what you should do. You need to be cool with who you are. And later, if you do that, guess what? Her type will be you. So tell me, what music do you like?
Well, you know, play the violin, so I do like classical. But I like classic rock too. I like a lot of 80s Michael Jackson.
That's cool. Do you like rap music? I like rap music.
Yeah, a bit. I'm not as familiar with it though.
She mirrors your posture. What does that mean? She doesn't trust you. Mimicking your posture is a sign that she's hypervigilant and on the edge. This is a bad sign. She's feeling attracted to you because...
After 10-15 minutes to speaking to a girl, if you notice that your postures are kind of matching and she followed your lead there, then it means that she's very comfortable, relaxed with you and probably attracted.
I think it's important to know what people want, right?
Yeah.
So it's good that... I think it's maybe a personal question, but I'm glad that... I'm glad that we both know what each other likes.
Yeah, I think so.
Tell her she needs to sleep with your friends if you date. I'd have to look at the other options.
There's something I think we should cover before we go any further. I have like specific things that I look for in a girl, like I told you.
Sure, yeah.
But there's one other thing, which is that I've got really good friends. I'm really close to them and I like, you know, sharing with them and stuff. So if we get together, really from time to time, I just want you to sleep with my friends. You know, there's one, Mahmoud, who's a very nice guy, my friend Alex, and all lovely guys. You're going to like them. I mean, you can Mahmoud. Say, but I'm sure you will like them. And just from time to time, you know, I'll be watching from a cupboard or whatever. And you just need to...
No.
There's nothing to... Think about it a little bit and wait until you meet them.
I'll get back to you. In the meantime, there's a good street corner. You can maybe find a girl like that.
Street corner? Which street is it?
Now, although we really should believe that it's bros before girls, you don't need to bring Mahmoud and Alex into your sex life. You know, it should be between you and the girl, at least to begin with.
Dick, Alex, and Mahmoud have definitely done something. Anyway, tell her that you prefer dating bisexual women. C, say that sex is very important to you and ask if she is good in bed. D, ask what color her eyes are as an excuse to get close. E, tell her you only date girls that meet a minimum booty threshold. These all suck, man. Sorry. D is obviously the right answer, but I'm so afraid if I pick any of these other ones that it's going to be a pass. Playful laughter and all that sort of thing. You guys are saying D? Really? You guys want this to end well. All right.
What color are your eyes? Are down they for blue it. Or kind of gray blue?
Bluish gray?
Excellent, well done. This is one of my personal favorites. It's a very smooth way to go from just having a conversation to having a really intimate, spicy moment.
Poor Mike. Thanks, lady. Thanks for the 22 minutes. That we do. I'm having a nice time and I'm really happy we met. Lean forward and kiss. B, say you look like you're imagining kissing me. C, can I kiss you? D, listen, I want to kiss you, but can you chew this gum first? E, I don't think I've ever been in love before, but I think I'm starting to feel that way with you leaning for kiss. Gum. Gum. Have you got like a extra sponsor or something with that? This gum.
Listen, I just really want to kiss you right now, but first, do you want to... bit of gum? I mean, your choice. If you want to have some.
Is it bad? Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah, did you maybe have some garlic?
No, I just had the tea that you got.
Okay, well, that's okay. Well, here it is if you want it.
Thanks.
Oh, Vito, that's just rude, man.
E's super creepy. Just go with A. wasn't rude. Vito. I thought Vito was spelled V-E-T-O. No, it's not his name. C-A. Oh, is A kind of weird? Can I kiss you? Is nice. You want C? B is the best option. You look like you're imagining. That's so... No. No. I think C's the best.
Listen, can I kiss you?
I mean...
Would you mind?
It's not always attractive to ask if you, you know...
Isn't it?
It's more fun if you just kind of go for it.
Oh, come on!
Really? I should just jump on you?
I mean, maybe not so extreme, but you shouldn't...
Okay, you ready?
You shouldn't
ask.
I'm
gonna do it. Are you ready?
Let's try again another time.
Okay. And I won't ask.
Right.
Got
Shit,
it.
You guys were wrong.
Really? You had to ask? No, all wrong.
You were wrong. We still got Casanova though.
When someone does something like 51%. This, you know, charity, something
Wait,
that,
is that
they
cool,
really
55%.
Care about, don't tease it, don't take the piss, don't be rude about it, connect on it. You're suggesting a dishonest course of action, so think about what that says
That's
about you.
That's not wrong at all. We get consent
Lies will
in 2018.
Get you into trouble, and unless you move very, very fast, you're going to get caught out. And even if you don't get caught out, it's a recipe for disaster. So if you're not satisfied with where you are in life, work to change that so that you never need to lie. Yep, yep. When you have something that you like doing, why not be a little bit passionate about it?
I need to quickly wake myself up so we can do some more. She was not way out of his league. The fact that that was probably one of the best I've gone... Okay, no, it wasn't one of the best, but apparently 55% means that I did well better than usual, so... Alexa, we're going to be seeing her more soon in future episodes, so get... Brace yourself. Because she's ready. Hopefully she doesn't remember what happens in the past episodes because I weren't 100%. I badly need water, so I'll be right back.
Oh. about your car in the middle of the street. Open up the trunk, let the bass beat. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. You gotta.
Hey everyone, I'm sorry, I'm getting really, exhausted. I think I can try one more I know I'm probably gonna have to sleep. I'm like rotating my schedules so I'm more American and European friendly. And it's gonna be fine after a week of doing it, but it's wrecking me for the first few, for the first week. Australian, right? It's like 10 a.m. Elliot, thanks for the sub. Oh, welcome back to Fritupia. It'll get better. It will. It's good for me. It means I can avoid peak hour people. Like at the gym and shopping. That. So it's good for more than just streaming. So don't think you're special, but yeah, it's mostly for this. $22, thanks so much for the sub. I want to make an episode of this sort of thing. It seems like the most fun thing to film in all seriousness. It seems super fun to film. So many weird options. Some of the winning options are just so strange. It's just funny. McLaney, thanks for the 15 months. I can imagine that there's articles out there being like, this is just disgraceful, it's just awful. It's meant to be just funny, right? I need to get fat. I'll force Fast Fee to play this game, sure. Hopefully she doesn't see any of this. And whipping your dick around is never a pass. It's actually absurd. Okay, we have so many episodes to go. There, 4-4. And I'm really sad that some of these weren't perfect. We got Wingman, Office, First Date Kate. Oh, so we don't see Alexa again? Did we not unlock the next level? Satura, thanks for the sim. You've never wanted a guy to just whip it out in any situation? Not really. I don't know that you or any other females. I don't know any females in chat right now that would be like, oh, your dick's whipped out. And then would... I... No. I can't quite picture that. I would like to see this game... Seducer women version. I think that'd be funny too. He'll ask, is everything all right? And all you'll have six options and they'll all be there. Yeah, I'm fine. Okay, direct day game. A sunny day in the park and you see a beautiful lady walking on her own. Do you have what it takes to get her to agree to go on a date with you? Instant date or phone number? Let's check you up to normal level. Damn it.
Yep, nice one. You definitely want to be in front and you want to pay attention to the amount of space.
I learned that from the first time I interrupted
room,
a lady on the street. Don't worry, I've been listening, Richard. Bedroom dick. How will you get her attention? I just saw you and wanted to say I think you look really nice. I saw you and I knew if I didn't come over and say hi, I'd be kicking myself all day. I must say that you have the most sexy walk. Pick her up, literally.
Yo, hey, excuse me.
Yeah?
Hang on a second, look over there. Is that a fox in those trees?
What?
Have a look.
What?
Don't touch me! Let go!
What are you doing?
Why not?
You're weirdo.
Come back. I'm pretty sure this is illegal. It's also very dangerous. You could get hernias, many different spinal disorders, and she could beat you, so don't do it.
It's true. He's very thoughtful. Excuse me, but you're attractive. Do you think I could get your number? Ask what I want to say. Let's go with the eye kicking myself in the game, kicking myself all day. That's his wife IRL. No.
Oh, hey, excuse me. Hang on a second. Look, I just saw you, and if I didn't let's see the chemistry. I'd definitely regret it all day.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for sure. This is a nice option for a daytime opener. It's sincere, so you can always say it anytime you see a girl that you're very attracted to, and it brings out a smile in them, makes them feel good. So even if she does have a boyfriend or something, you're actually doing good work by going around and saying this to women. I'm Richard, by the way.
I'm Kate.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
And what are you up to today?
I'm going to meet a friend now.
Hang on a second. Is it a boy or a girl?
It's a girl.
Okay, that's good. And look, hope you don't mind me asking, but we're in a park. Yeah?
Right.
And you're wearing heels and a dress. What's that about?
I just had an interview.
Oh yeah? Looking for a job?
Yes, I am.
Guess that she's looking for a job as a stripper. Ask why she doesn't just find a rich man and not work. Say that sure she'll get the job, she seems sophisticated. Ask what job she's looking for. Say that she seems smart and attractive and that any employer would be nuts not to hire her.
What job could you have? I'm gonna guess.
Okay.
Stripper.
Oh, how dare you? How could you think
I
look like a stripper? Your mom looks like a stripper.
My mom?
Yes!
Well, maybe a little bit, but... Now, just because we love strippers, we can't project this stripper image on every girl that we meet, especially this one who looks so sweet and unstripper-esque. Maybe you could have said that.
There are so many things that happened in the past 10 seconds that I would love to comment on, but I just can't. I'm overwhelmed. Too many things. But like, I just want to see his mum. Should we just do just D? Ask what job she's looking for. Yeah, you can feel the chemistry between these two. I will think D or B. No, D. D C D C D C D C. Washington.
So what job are you looking for?
I want to be an administrator in a restaurant.
In this case, you do need a bit more information, so asking another question is the right choice. You said you just had an interview over there. What was that?
Just in the restaurant over there.
Ah, there's the restaurant right on the park, isn't there?
Yeah, exactly.
That's quite a fancy one. That's a pretty good place to work.
I like it.
And is it, I think it's Italian food, if I'm not
mistaken,
yeah,
it's right? Italian, Mediterranean cuisine and stuff.
Well, that's good, because it's very tasty, but for me, I don't know, if I worked there, and if they had free food, I'd just be, I don't know, like, getting huge.
Really?
Yeah, you need to find out if they have free food there, if they do. Don't know.
Sorry. I just had a thought. I immediately saw this answer.
You'd be perfect for this because of the way you look and you're a young girl. I just need one more thing. Well, I'll tell you, do you have a car?
Yes, I do.
Okay, well, I need someone to drive because I had someone working for me and then now they can't anymore.
Okay.
But basically, you just need to drive across the border like a couple times a week and just meet my friends and they're sending me some things regularly. You just bring it back into the country.
What?
Very simple and quite a big money.
What do you
mean? Couple G's a week.
I mean, what do you mean?
Just, have you seen the movie Transporter with Jason Statham?
Oh, God.
By driving less fast.
You mean drugs?
You don't need to know what you're driving, do you? Like, you're just, oh, I'm driving a car, I don't know, I'm a girl.
You must have definitely taken some of your stuff to be discussing that with me.
Well, not today, I did last night, but...
So that's his wife. Like,
unfortunately, she declined my offer. So saying, if you're watching this and you do have a vehicle, then get in touch. Maybe we sort something out.
Yeah, this is his wife. He's done. Yeah. Damn. Sorry, I'm zoning out. Cool, I hope you get a job somewhere nice so you can give me free food. Suggest she works for you, cooking and providing other services. Say that you know the bosses of a few restaurants. I can put her in touch. D-E-E-D-D-D-D-D-D-D-D. Isn't B the best option? After E, of course.
Well, I've got an idea, right? I like food.
Okay.
And you're kind of in the industry.
Yeah.
So how about you come and cook for me a few times a week, and I'll pay you, obviously.
Okay.
And then the job could come with certain benefits.
Oh, well.
What say you?
I can see what you mean. But how much it pays?
I don't know. I mean, we could talk about it. We could say like a hundo a day or whatever.
Okay, and which food do you like? I mean, I need to know.
I like Italian food, like pizza, okay. Pasta. Yeah. But then sometimes I want healthy stuff, like yeah. Salad and whatever.
Okay, and how many times a week do I need to have sex with you?
Ooh, well, I mean, I get quite tired sometimes in the night, so not okay. Every night. Maybe like three is enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's, what do you say?
That sounds good. Yeah, I will call you, you know? I will definitely.
Yeah, okay.
You.
Yeah, if you
sure,
tell me.
Sure,
hang on a second. You don't have my number. Hey.
She handled that like a boss.
No. All wrong. If you
though,
want to get a girl like
handled
that,
handled it like
first
a boss.
You hire her as a cook, and then slowly you introduce the extra benefits and services. That's the way to do it.
So B or D, which one's better? Almost got her. Yes. That was definitely an almost got her moment. Guys are leaning towards D. Yeah, sure.
I really do hope you get a job somewhere very nice.
Yeah, thank you.
But mainly so I can get free food. I just come down and say, I know that girl Kate, and she said to just give me loads of food, and you know she'll pay for it later.
That's strange, but
no, I'm
okay.
Joking. But would be pretty cool.
Yeah, funny.
Good one. This is a playful response. Should get a laugh, and is the way to go.
So, what is your job?
My job. Well, I'm a salesman.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's nice. What do you sell?
Now I sell software, and actually I started selling like cars and even double glazing back in the day, but now I sell software, so it's a lot more relaxed, and it's quite good. I like it. Good being a salesman. You get to meet lots of people.
Oh, I guess. Right. Yeah.
And tell me, you know, I was just talking to my friends and they're looking for jobs at the moment as well.
Oh.
And they told me that they're kind of bitching about immigrants all the time. So what do you think? Because you're like unemployed, looking for a job. What do you think about the immigrant situation?
That came out of nowhere. What the? He literally is going to slip every single thing to trigger and to get a response.
I think it's okay. I actually like the idea very much because immigrants bring diversity and, you know, it's a good thing.
What did it say? Sorry, I didn't realize. Did it say make it opposite of yours. Oh, my bad. I fucked up.
Yeah, actually, I totally agree with you. I think you're right.
That was awkward. Can you send me back?
This is all right. It's okay to agree, but remember that if you think something different, then you should say it and you should persuade her.
I didn't
be persuasive, be logical.
I didn't realize and it would have a I didn't read.
But not bad.
Okay, I just.
Well, you know what? Regardless of whether you're for or against,
you asked me what her opinion was for some cool reason, and I was like, I need to sleep. Yeah, it's really, it's
like
my
in
bedtime.
England, we've got
I need
so
to go
tasty
to sleep.
Indian food. It's just delicious.
I fucked up. I thought the question was just like, oh. What opinion do you want? What opinion would she have? And I was like, probably for immigration. I'm gonna go to sleep and continue this day stream tomorrow is what I'm gonna do. Probably restart this day too. Thank you for the stream. I'm sorry it was super short. It's because I was quite late. So getting used to this new schedule. But I promise I'll do it for tomorrow's morning stream. Evening stream. What time is it for Europe and US right now? I don't know. So like I said, thanks to the 2000 bits. I'm going to be playing Fortnite my next stream, and then the next stream I'll play with more of this. How about that? Sounds good. Sounds good. Super good. Fit.